Okay, folks, I apologize. I did have to cut the song about slowly having sex with Smash a little bit short. That's what I've been told it translates to. Apparently, it's meant to actually be a compliment, not a literal translation, but hey, whatever floats your boat down there for you guys who idolize Smash. So, we're getting into this. We are on game three. This set has gone the distance. It is going for speed. I am not all alone in my time of need because we've got PQMZ here with me. What do you expect in this game? Yeah. I think a really strong hero all around the Doxy, and I have to imagine anybody who's played offlane in the past few years knows how to play that hero.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah, yes indeed, thank you. So, anyway,
Ember Spirit.
Yeah, so, either way, we've got the Ember Spirit finally making it through, and we're gonna get to see Smash's Ember Spirit, so I think we're in for a treat. I certainly enjoy seeing it. I do prefer Conker.
Winter Wyvern.
Radiant team pick.
I don't know. That's the type of reason I would love to interview these players after the game, because I do wonder how their drafting goes. I know some teams actually have a drafter who ignores everybody and will give them heroes that maybe they're not good on, you know? They'll be like, look, we need this hero. I know you don't know how to play it, but suck it up for the team. So. Yeah.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah. Now, we have got Doxy. Oh. Okay, last time I saw Ewolves run Potom, they also ran. They hit all of their arrows, first of all, unassisted, which was disgusting and beautiful at the same time, much like Mirana with her selling mayonnaise. But also, they did pick a Kunkka, so I don't think Kunkka's in it for this game. I'm just hopeful. You know me, I'm stupid. They ban out the Huskar, though. Has he been banned this set? I feel like no. Okay. Yeah.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
And I think it's really hard to play the Mirana because she's not a great carry. And if you play her as support, you have to hit every arrow. It is so difficult to actually hit your arrows. Hmm.
10 seconds remaining. Radiant team ban.
100%. So, Broodmother banned out by Unknown. They don't want to face up against the Broodmother that they just ran. I always find that kind of funny. But it makes sense that they've made it clear they don't want to pick it up since they have the Doxia. And I wonder what else we'll be seeing here. It feels like maybe an Earthshaker or something. Not something Unknown wants to play against.
Reserve time.
I have to say, I have seen some great Vacuum Echo Slams. I've also seen some great Vacuum Echo Slams ruined by a Wyvern who Winter Cursed too early, causing the damage reduction. Pick. 100%. Now, we have got Gyrocopter, Doxia, Wyvern. That's a lot of AoE damage. At the same time, Winter's Curse isn't going to save you from Flame God Searing Chains. And Ewolves can Still go with the AA that they had a fabulous time on last game.
10 seconds remaining. Radiant team pick.
Yeah. Unknown might want to go with the Quap here, just because, as you mentioned, you got a Morana with arrows flying at you, you got Tusk who can snowball in on you. A lot of the mids that are popular right now are going to have a really rough time against this aggression coming out of E-Wolves.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah, sorry, I whiffed on that. I thought it was someone else. Yeah, we all do that sometimes. I'm sorry. I whiffed. Shame me. Shame me now. Well, everybody in chat, feel free to shame me so I don't ever do it again. This is what happened. We've been casting for a while, and also I may or may not be focusing on this avocado I'm eating because I'm pretty peckish. But yeah, what is Unknown pick here? I feel like a lot of the standard mids, they're just going to get rolled. Like, you pick Alina, you're dead. You pick, I don't know.
Alchemist.
Okay, and Alchemist, he is very squishy. As long as you catch him outside of that chemical rage, I don't know if I would agree that he was the pick here. And
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I think what's popular right now is the Naga Siren ripoff. The old days of the Blink Abyssal Blade Alc, I think, are behind us firmly, which makes me sad.
Windranger at your service.
Radiant team back.
Yep. I was gonna say, I love this Windrunner. As long as you catch the Alc and shackle him before he gets off the chemical rage, you can actually kill him pretty easily. At the same time, she's not gonna have the easiest time in lane against the Alc. It really depends. He can kind of zone her with that acid spray. At the same time, she should be able to get good denies.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant team pick.
And also, I don't know whether this will be the Van or the Smash Windrunner. Smash's Windrunner is another thing that makes me... Windrunners in general, but Smash does this to me a lot, where in the games I've cost of E-Wolves, I miss their kills because he snipes them from across the map. Like, how am I meant to know that he was power-shotting all the way across and we have an Abaddon? So, is this an aggro try? Yeah, I'm not 8,000 matchmaking points, I'm sorry. But yeah, this isn't a... Well, that's because they're on Americas. We're not all, you know, falsely inflated MMR like you Euros. But back into the game, we got an Undying. Oh, yeah. We got an Undying, we've got an Abaddon. I am really enjoying this, and we've got ourselves a Game 3.
As long as the Abaddon job, which is not an easy job, but if you can do it right, confront that aggression and let his horse get online early.
I would not want to be the Abaddon here. I just feel like you're going to constantly be trying to save your teammates and getting yelled at for not doing it. But they can also potentially have some aggression coming out from Unknown. Wyvern, with that Arctic Bone, with that Splinter Blast, Abaddon actually has quite a bit of damage output if you can get the Aquatic Shield to explode, or maybe you're just going to slow them with the Curse of Avernus. But we have a 5-man smoke rotation, and they want to snowball someone. E-Wolves getting ready to do it. We'll introduce the players after somebody dies, and it looks like it's going to be Hoshimiki. Now, taking a lot of damage. No, they want to kill. Oh, gosh, they want to make sure he doesn't get the bounty rune. He'll respawn before it. Takes the snowball. A bunch of people picked up in it. They've got the arrow hitting as well, and this is a very dead alchemist.
And he skilled Cold Embrace. This game is, like...
already.
That's just problematic.
Yeah.
First off, you picked your supports to stop.
No, no, they have to stop him from getting the bounty rune. What are they doing? They want more kills on E-Wolves, and I think they're missing the bigger picture of the bounty runes. Oh, they're going in again, Windrunner. Now they realize they're like, shit, we're going to give them the bounty runes, but I think Van is going to go down here. And Smash and Van are in the wrong part of town. They need to woke it up, but of course she has Bloody Shackle Shot. She doesn't have the Shackle of Dreams. There's a Searing Chain. She's going to go down, and they get a kill onto the Doxia. But they do manage to get the bounty rune. What?
Killed the Doxia?
No, they get a kill onto, as in the Doxia gets a kill on him, like he got a kill.
Oh, okay, sorry.
It was poorly said.
I'm
look.
Please,
if you could, just pretend I'm perfect and bear with the cards, that would
Hey, I try, but when I'm tired, these errors just, you know.
Yeah,
however,
they accumulate.
They don't get the bounty on the Elk, so
yeah,
the Windrunner of Death is warranted.
It. Yeah, I actually think it's worth it to get the death there. And here comes some arrows. It's gonna hit! That was, I think, I don't know how long it was. The Aphotic Shield saving his life, though. That was, like, at least a 4-second arrow, right?
That was 4 or 5 seconds. Sure. He shot it from, like, here. That's definitely enough.
I'm pretty sure Masoku should be called the M-God and not Mystico. And speaking of that, let's do some introductions super late because we had a lot of action, folks. We've got Mystico as M-God on Undying. We've got Stinger playing that Tusk. We've got Masoku on Mirana. Mid, we're going to have Smash on his famous Ember Spirit. And finally, that means Van up on the Windrunner going against Adolxia. Going to be interesting to see how that
turns
out.
The Wyvern's getting gone on.
Oh, yeah, the cold embrace, but will it be enough? He's healing up a shit ton. I think he still goes down to auto attack. They have another Decay and Ice Shards as well. He's not escaping, and now maybe Gyrocopter's in No Man's Land. When is the next Decay up? No, I think it's too long. He's taking a while. They need to hit this Decay, but Undying, he doesn't want to go in ham. He's taking too much damage, and he backs out. Gonna be A-okay on the Gyro.
He gets a kill mid on... Okay, that's obviously the Abaddon. Smash thinking he can get a kill there, and the Abaddon just turning it around.
Being a cheeky bugger, as we like to say. So, this game, already off to the same start that the first one was. We have 2 kills a minute. It looks like... Okay, that was just him taking... I thought Undying was going down. It was just the Decay stacks wearing off.
I wouldn't be surprised if he goes for his rune and denies to rush. But he opts to eat a Tango, so he doesn't want to do that.
Yeah.
I'm not sure why you
No, I think he's gonna, he's gonna deny himself. He's like, I shouldn't have done that.
That's just autopilot Dota.
Yeah.
And to quickly finish off the introductions, we have Zetok on the Abaddon. I don't have a clue who the Elk is. Is it Aton?
That is Aton. Aton, that is him.
I don't actually want to say the name. I see him on my screen.
No, I think it says Peru is sore, shiny, soft. It could be Peru is soft. Maybe it's a very squishy country and he feels it's a soft one in general. How did they hit that arrow? He's gonna self-stun. Does he suicide himself? No! How the shit did he hit that arrow? How did he know he would walk back?
You just know these things as a player, honestly. Like, it's impressive to watch, but being able to read people's movements is really not that hard when... It's actually harder to read, like, retard's movement. You don't know what they're gonna do. Like, he knows he's gonna move that way.
So
what I'm tackled by the Ember.
Yeah.
He's gonna self-stun.
Oh my goodness, yeah, he's gonna self-stun and now Smash, he's just gonna walk it off, get Searing Chains on both of them. There is no follow-up there. All I heard from what you said.
Greedy on the ducks here. Someone's name who doesn't exist, so I'm guessing
that's
it's Kataru.
Yeah, Kataru.
Then...
I call him Hoshimiki.
We have Yoshihara Emma, the... I have no fucking clue who
I don't watch enough anime for this shit, is what I'm saying.
No, I mean... hate on anime, but I just don't watch any of it because I don't watch TV at all.
I would. I'm just backlogged, and you have to do your full attention to anime because you can't watch it dubbed. You have to watch it subbed. M-God taking quite a bit of damage. Going to take a rocket barrage as well. He does have another decay up soon. He drops the tombstone. Now here comes the snowball. They snowball on the gyro, though. I feel like the easier kill would have been the wyvern. And now doing a lot of damage, but with the decay stacks, going to be fine. The splinter ball still hasn't killed up M-God. He finally goes down, and this was not the fight they needed to turn. I think they had to snowball onto the wyvern, make sure she couldn't get off that winter's curse. And they're going to get fat bounty gold. Sigil. Radiant's
bottom tower. Yeah, definitely going for the greedy kill. Fortunately, how it went down, there was a creep wave like here, and they went here, so Potom couldn't get an arrow. She tried to like leap in and get one, but yeah. I think the wyvern took point blank. So a lot of their damage was missing there.
In the meantime, discussing these lanes, we've got a lot of farm coming out on Greedy. He is having a great time here. It doesn't feel like Van can do anything against him. Although Van is getting decent farm as well, you know? They're both gonna get fat in this top lane. And we have another engagement on mid, but I don't think you should be there, Smash. Yeah, he backs out after doing a lot of damage to that Alk. On the upside for Smash, he's gonna have the level advantage here just because there have been two mid for so long. Oh, here comes the stun. He gets the Searing Chains. Is he gonna be able to throw it? Alk does, and it's quite a bit of damage, but Undying in the bottom lane, look guys, I need you to one kill at a time on the map, come on. M-God's thinking about going ham, but he is gonna maybe pay the price for that one again. He uses Soul Rip to make sure he stays alive. I wanted to discuss lanes and how they should be going, but...
This is about right. The aggression's obviously something that's hard to account for, but one big thing to note is... Wolf's got this ward off at the start of the game when they went for the level 1 kill, so Alk's stacks are not as efficient as they would like to be, because the Abaddon's constantly sitting here. He needs some way of getting back into the game, speed-wise, and that's generally by stacking and leashing XP when the Alk takes it. However, he's not even opting to go for the levels in Acid Spray.
Yeah,
makes this ancient stack for the Gyro, so it's going to be a much later time where the Abaddon can get his experience.
I did want to ask about that. I feel like maxing Acid Spray, that's usually the build I see. He actually is maxing the stun, it looks like, and maybe the Grievous Greed. Not sure which one he's going to opt in for. And actually, the Chemical Rage has ended. Let's see what they can do here. Searing Chains. I don't think Smash has the DPS. He definitely does. Oh, the arrow won't hit this time. Not going to thread the needle on those creeps and smash Remnants away. But now Masoku might be the one taking the damage. No, instead it's Undying. Mystico going down and going to feed them a nice tombstone. Is he going to farm zombies here? Oh, he doesn't.
Nah, the tower would have killed it, so okay. Zombie farming not an option.
Yeah, I believe that's a bug. I don't think it's meant to be in Reborn. I don't know if it's been patched recently, but I saw it in another game recently.
But they used to give gold, and they count as creeps, so I don't
top lane,
we're
gonna go down.
Happening.
Yeah, I just caught the tail end of that kill. We're counting that as caught, folks watching at home.
Another self-stun mid, but he doesn't... worry, because he has a regen. Yep. He's actually doing pretty well in this lane, considering his build.
Yeah.
I like the fact he wants to be more active, though, as opposed to the AFK farm.
Yeah.
I still really like the level 3, though. He's actually gone 2-2-2, so going back for it.
It certainly synergizes well with whatever else is going on around here, and... We have a really bad power shot coming out from Van. Either way, looking at the bigger picture, I'm assuming I could be wrong. We don't know what type of Alk this is. I think we call it Poor Man's Naga Siren Alk is very popular. If they do this, Ewolves is going to need bots up on Smash, I think, to in any way respond to the split push they're going to be handed.
I definitely don't think that's the way he's going to go. Just because of the fact he's gone for this build. I feel like the Radiance is still a really good option on the hero. He just synergizes very well. And the Mischance is definitely relevant. They're actually diving bottom, but they're going to cooldown. So
they're also being shits up top. And yeah, the dive bottom, maybe not the right thing to do with these TPs in. But they're in the snowball. They're going on to Kataru on that gyrocopter. He's taking quite a bit of damage. Splinterball is doing work too, but the tombstone is still active. Nasuku, Mystico probably going to fall here and they kill off the tombstone. Mystico, will the Splinterball hit him? It won't do enough because of all those decays. But can Hoshimiki get some auto attacks in? And they get it with that Mist Coil, and a beautiful Ice Shards placement. Gonna work out. I think he's fine. He's gonna walk it off. So, Mango Eaton not gonna get the kills.
Considering he snowballed into three heroes, pretty much, that worked out pretty well. I think they were both dead, actually, if it wasn't for Noble, so it was really heads up play by him. He's actually diving mid on the Ember.
Yeah, again, he's got Windrunner to help him out. This Sun isn't going to be a self-stun, but she's getting more than enough damage. The Shackle doesn't latch, but they don't need it. And there's a casual undying nearby just in case.
May as well, right? Obviously wanting to be there if there's any more backup coming from the unknown squad. These Splinter Blasts have been doing so much damage.
Yeah, I mean, it does huge amounts of damage, and it has a really short cooldown, this spell. I think it's, it's 7 seconds, so I was going to... I'm gonna say 8, but we'll pretend I knew all along. I think as well, it's really, they're doing a good job constantly bringing the pressure onto Alchemist. If you can kill off a ton, even though he hasn't maxed Scribble's Greed, he's the top farmer. So killing him off repeatedly, always good. But let's see if Masoku can land another Arrow of Dreams. As you said, as long as Greedy isn't a retard, this is easy. And in fact, that's what you're talking about. He didn't realize that Greedy would get stunned by the Shackle.
I think that was just...
Missed time?
He had to leap first there.
Mm.
A professional Podden player would know that, but obviously he's just not on par. Arrows this game?
I feel like Marana hasn't been in the meta for a while, and she got a buff last patch, so...
I mean, that's like... insignificant buff.
Well, she's been picked a lot more this patch compared to zero last patch, so I feel like... either the buff or something else has changed in the meta, making her more viable. Are there players right now who play her professionally? I am not sure.
I don't know. I've only been watching the games I've been casting recently, so...
Yeah, that'll... Welcome to my life. Either way, we have some rotations down bottom. They don't want them to get this tower for free. And they do have some kill potential here. Again, M-God, you need a Decay of Dreams to keep yourself alive. You can also go for the Soul Rip, but no one's nearby. Pops the zombies up first, and there's going to be an Ice Shield. Where is the Snowball? Here comes Ember Spirit, Searing Chains, and he doesn't have level 6 yet on the Avernus, but they are going to get a kill onto Alk. He might go down here. He pops the Chemical Rage, and they're probably all just going to walk it off. I say a smash. He actually goes for some scouting, catching out on some stacks. There was really shit English there.
I obviously just want to quickly clarify this. He's a really good bottom player.
Sarcastic. I know.
Yeah, Twitch chat might hate me a bit for that. I just want to clarify.
No. I think his bottom has been clearly doing work on Masoku, and even though I clearly don't play up there with the greats, I'm sure he would arrow me all the time. No innuendo.
Phrasing.
I just realized that could... Yeah, I'm sorry.
Phrasing.
I'm so sorry. I'm really bad at this. Oh.
I mean, not a bad thing to be arrowed, right?
What? In Dota, quote, yes.
Quote, arrowed.
Oh, yeah. In Dota, it's horrible, though, right? You're going to get Tossi's screwed
catching
over.
Out the Alpha.
Can he get the kill, though? I know... Oh, I don't think he has enough damage. He does use the punch. He gets it. I am a little bit surprised, and it was very close that Chemical Rage was coming off of cooldown as he went for that gank, and it looks like Searing Chains, Abaddon's still only level 4. I think this is enough damage. No, the Aphotic Shield is going to split, and with the Ice Shard should be good, but can they get any sort of return? No. Greedy's here, and Smash isn't someone you can catch onto on this Ember Spirit. And now off Wyvern is trying to kill off Mr. Ice Shards, of course, knowing, oh, he uses the Winter's Curse even, and they've got a cooldown. This is a very dead Tusk.
He's
going to... Yeah, I think Snowball would delay the inevitable. I guess it's worth it there to make them take a little bit more time. Oh my goodness, Smash is gonna get vacuumed back! He's gonna remnant all over the place.
I actually kind of like the build Smash is going for this game. I really like maxing Flugard personally, but he's opted quite earlier just to be able to set up the arrows from bottom and be more aggressive with his hero in general.
Yeah,
actually
sorry
going
about the
bottom as well with the stun.
Oh gosh,
don't think
guys!
It's gonna matter, though.
I just want to take a sip of my drink, so everything is good.
See,
but
fortunate, I can do that while you're talking.
I know,
I
talk a lot.
As much as you.
Yeah, you're very lucky. Either way, we're gonna have a full engagement, and the Chemical Rage, it's gonna be on cooldown at the same time. They might lose top tower, but they want to go ham. It's as you said, they're ready. Smash has a DD. He's gonna do a lot of damage, even though he does. Oh, we've got more TBs coming in. This might be a mistake. They know the Winter's Curse is on cooldown, but looking like they've decided maybe this wasn't the play to make. Smash is gonna remnant right into a cooldown. Vacuum almost saves his life. He dodges one with the Sleight of Fist, but it's not gonna be enough. And this team fight is going horribly. Arrow may land, but there is gonna be no follow up. And goodbye, Mystico. Sturged up, making sure he gets it. And Masoku is like, I may as well just farm. My teammates are all dying.
That's just such a hard play to go for when you don't have the vision.
Oh, really nice Snowball away coming out of Stinger, making sure he doesn't go down there to the gyro feed them another kill. and even dropping his item, though, he's really close. This game is super even, or it was until that kill. Looks like it's now swinging a bit in favor of Unknown, but before that, this game had been very, very even.
The Elk just has his relic now, so a bit of a slower Radiance, but considering the build he went and the amount of time he spent dead slash fighting middle, not bad. Still topping the net worth by quite a lot.
Yeah. This is the problem, though. I feel like as an alchemist, you're expected to be way, way ahead of the curve, and he is only ahead by about 1,000. Although that's
definitely
increasing as we
speak.
Definitely
enough at this stage, though.
Yeah, it does look... It looks like it's going to be the Radiance. So.
Yeah, I definitely expect him to go for at least the Radiance. But then I think he's going to transition away from the normal build.
Oh, and the smoke is going to actually surge right into it. They drop the tombstone. They should be able to catch up Warburn here. I don't think they're getting greedy. Immediately uses the Winter's Curse. Can't he flap away? But there is a snowball arrow going to land as well. War's Punch not quite enough. They finally got the damage, but that was a beautiful vacuum wall. They're also getting the stun. That's still no ult on to Mr. Abaddon, but there is a cooldown. They need to get the hell out of Dodge. Do they have detection? I don't see any detection. And Tombstone, they finally knocked it out. They're going back in. Windrunner gets the Shackle of Dreams to make sure they finish him off. And this Chemical Rage is going to, it's actually going to be up for years. He might be able to toss something. M-God, I think you're dying. He takes a lot of damage and he has gone down. And somehow they kill off Alchemist. Windrunner, I think, using just mass damage. I was really impressed they killed him through the Chemical Rage. They forced a buyback out of Gyro, and Ewol's understanding that it is their time to get the hell out of Dodge. Masoku hiding in the trees. Yeah, and that is...
Ideal timing for Ewol's to fight.
Oh gosh, he actually came back in on Smash.
Yeah, they definitely want to go for more here. If they can catch the Gyro,
yeah, they're going to have the Searing Chains. They can set up an arrow if they are so inclined. Taking a lot of damage anyway, but you know the cooldown's down, and even though Smash is going to get stunned, they have a Snowball coming out. War's Punch should be there to follow up. Doesn't need it with the Ice Shards, and you have no wall, so that is a silly, silly vacuum, Doxia. And he's going to probably eventually follow the mech doing good work, and he surged up under the tower. Maybe they don't want to follow him here. Ice Shards off the mark. Searing Chains is bad, but the arrow! The Soku.
Oh no, bottom's trapped. She has to hit creeps. Team help.
No, she's fine. She's gonna have Windrunner help her out, and yeah, a really nice play there all around. At the same time,
they're
it looks like they're mid.
Out the Undying mid.
But again, they got a bunch of kills and they only lost the Undying. Windrunner Van, who started, he had a decent start up top. He was suddenly lost it in creeps. Well, he is upping his worth, and he has a Blink Dagger already, and with that he gets a Shackle again. Chemical Rage not making it as good, but this Chemical Rage, it is coming off, and now they're going to use that Cold Embrace. Windrunner, she's going to Power Shot through it. They need to burn him a little bit more, and he goes down. Finally has that borrowed time, but it might be not enough, but there's the Winter's Curse of Dreams. They're still going to catch Mr. Abaddon, and they get the Wyvern to boot, unfortunately losing their top net worth in the Windrunner, but I think you're happy, because now Smash has eclipsed her. And holy Hannah, this game is full of death. We are at 2 kills a minute. Net worth a little bit in favor of E-Wolves, but it has been a bumpy, even ride.
I think you have to expect that, though, when you see E-Wolves draft. They're just going to run at you and cast spells, and it's probably going to work, unless you play really well around it.
Yeah.
I don't have the heroes to do it, but this Abaddon is just a null factor, because he's far behind. Going in on the Gyro here.
No, Gyrocopter looking like he's very dead. The arrow hits again, because of course it does, and gonna go down. The Abaddon, I feel like, has been doing...
stunned when he TP'd in.
Oh no, I totally missed that, and he's actually gonna walk away. The Searing Chains don't latch. There's gonna be a nice little power shot. Who... Just a Sigil is back here.
They might try and re-engage with this pop-ball. She has no arrows soon.
I think that they've been doing a really good job on the Abaddon despite the levels. Oh, they see him. They've got a sentry right on top of you, Mr. Tusk Stinger. You got to be careful. He's going to snowball away, making sure to get out. Windrunner, though, can back him up. Do they have anybody else? A really nice Ice Shards come out. Stinger in a lot of trouble. The arrow actually going to whiff for once in his life. But there is the Tombstone and the Shackle doing a lot of damage. There is no Winter's Curse this time. And they're just going down eventually, slowly, borrowed time, buffing them all up. And of course, that Cold Embrace keeping them alive. But the cooldown is... Whoa, no, never mind. Sleight of Fist gets the Wyvern. Shackle gets immediately purged off by the Aquatic Shield. M-God looking to be the one taking a lot of damage. Probably can't stand up to all of this with Smash. Coming back in with an Invis Rune. Can he do anything? Looks like he's going to think better of it.
I mean, they're trying, but there's a lot of chance in hell.
Yeah, I wanted to say, I think Abaddon's actually doing fantastic work considering what he's given. He's been purging off so many Shackles. Getting rid of a lot of people being in trouble from Morana Arrow as well. It's just this game is ridiculous. There's a lot of stuns coming out from E-Wolves, and Abaddon can't be in every lane saving everybody's life.
No, he can't, unfortunately. But that's why he's Abaddon, and he's barely picked.
Yeah. So, a little bit unfortunate for him there, but either way, I think doing a good job. Windrunner, she is approaching that Aghanim Scepter, gonna buff up her damage a bunch. I'm gonna do items, so tell me if someone's being slayed. We've got Abaddon just rocking the boots. He's poor. The Radiance is active, and the mischance in it added a few patches back, and it just really helps you out. I feel like it makes it much more viable on a lot of people. And of course, Windrunner here, making sure that she misses, forcing her into an MKB, maybe even forcing the Ember Spirit will be really nice. Mech is up on Darkseer as well. I think he should go Blink next. Do you think he'll go Guardian Greaves, though?
I'd favor the Blink, personally, because the way you Wolves are playing, they're kind of running into you, so having a way to counter-initiate on top of the Abaddon is just a lot
easier. Speaking of running into them, there is another arrow combo. No time for that cold embrace, and Darkseer is just going to TP out. They get themselves an easy support kill.
I think they'll take that, because they get the tower deny in favor of getting the kill, which is probably more money. However, the Wyvern had a decent amount of gold, so they probably don't know that, though.
Yeah, she was probably saving up that Blink Dagger, very popular first item on Wyverns, because of course that positioning for the Winter's Curse can be OP. And Smash, I don't think this is your part of town right now. You're strong, but I don't know if you're this strong. He's actually gone the drums, now working on his Battle Fury. I like this build, just because it is something where I feel like this game, he's been fighting so much. So.
Yeah, the drums helps a lot with your team.
And he dodges.
Definitely the more fight-orientated build as opposed to the Aquila.
Already out of charges, by the way. Mirana, despite being super rich or getting a lot of kill involvement, she is 3-0-8. Can we just talk about her impact for a second? 3-0-8 on a support Mirana? Oof. So.
Yeah, but they've been winning most of the engagement they're in, and she's fairly easy hero to not die on because you just stay pretty far back. Especially with the build he's gone, his Starfall's not... He hasn't been high level for most of the game. He's getting levels now, so it's going to start being more impactful in these fights. And he's actually right-clicking a decent amount because of the build he went. He's going to transition into more of a core than most bottoms, I feel like.
Yeah, Emgod going to take the casual stun there. Actually trying to maybe set up on Smash on bottom, but this is a hard kill, and he remnants away, and we have a smoke rotation coming out. They have to know this. I feel like they do. They could just snipe the courier here, and they saw the ward being placed with that sentry. They should know that they're there, but it's nighttime. He may have not been in vision. They miss out on the courier on the side of E-Wolves, and they're going to pop up the sigil. But they are going ham on Smash, and Smash locked down with that Wyvern ult. I don't know if this is the fight they want to take. They know a lot of big cooldowns are down, though, but you don't have to fight into the chemical rage, and that is rough. They vacuum back the Windrunner. She's going to manage to walk it off. I don't think Radiant's Bone is going to be enough. And the stun, she should. Oh, gosh. She's going to go down here. She's not going to get away in time. Goodbye, Van. And that is a huge amount of gold for the side of Unknown. And now they might even be able to find out Mr. Tusk. He's going to take a lot of damage, but it looks like they're backing off. I think
he's
going
fine.
For the wraparound smoke was a bit ambitious there when Smash was so far out of position.
That's just communication theme, though. Like, when your captain says we're coming from behind, you obviously want to put some pressure on them to either force them back or try and initiate for your team, but you can't get caught out. That's like the worst scenario you can have happen. So, puts Unknown back in the game, I feel like. E-Wolves were doing a really good job.
Oh, we have a very dead Tusk. He's going to take... Oh, he actually snowballs in. Means he won't take at least part of the cooldown. And here comes Undying, but I think this is just going to be a feed by E-Wolves. Where's the backup? Arrow hit on the gyrocopter. They're trying to take out this, but he's going to take remnants to the face. Comes out the mech. They actually get the bloody deny. Well done, but it's not going to be enough. And can they follow up going on to Mr. Alchemist? He doesn't have the chemical rage for another 10 seconds. Do they have enough damage with the Radiance Bone and everything? Here's some more lockdown for it, and I think this is a dead out. Power shot misses, but that is enough. And Abaddon, while he got the impressive deny, not enough. Also, Wyvern's Blink Dagger is up. She got that during that last fight.
Nice to have that in conjunction with the Darkseer, because you're normally quite far behind as a Wyvern, so having it at the similar time is really big.
Yeah, she survived a few team fights, and as you said, you can certainly get lockdown, force them to fight each other, while you also maybe have the illusions attacking or set up a nice vacuum wall combo. But we have a Midas on Tusk. He went it after the mech, I'm pretty sure, or maybe I'm just really oblivious to how this game has been going.
You are correct with that statement.
Oh. Which one? So,
I'll let you figure that one out.
We got the Aghanims coming out on Windrunner, so... That's going to be more damage for her. Her form slowed down a little bit since she hasn't been slaying all over the place, but she's still doing pretty damn well for herself. And Smash is almost at the Battle Fury. Pretty average timing on that. I believe this patch, the Battle Fury timing is 25 minutes. So.
Yeah, but I don't think that accounts for drums. We're normally like 1,000 more on top, so he's farming really well. 100 CS, 10 kills. It's not the highest amount of farm, but he's been really active this game, so it makes up for it. The Elk is opting to go for the Naga Siren-esque build. I don't mind the Mantra too much because it's still good when you're fighting. It gives you a way to dodge the arrows with the setup. You can also dodge Shackle Shots. You can dodge the Self-Stun on yourself. So, as long as he uses it well, it's pretty good. Just a farming tool, though, I don't like it as much.
Yeah. So we've got, oh wow, Van, being a little bit ham in the bottom lane, managing to catch on to that haste and walk it off.
I think he was trying to solo rush and then quickly realized, this isn't working.
Yeah, not exactly something I feel like Windrunner can do at level 13 with just a Blink and an Aghanim Scepter. So, not the bestest. But either way, ambitious. We've got things calming down. If she gets some backup, she can certainly do this. Their lineup, yeah.
Stunning
they...
bottom? I don't think he's going to be able to get the kill, though.
Aw, you say okay, that, but I'm pretty sure this is a very dead Mirana. Yeah, you can charge it up for years, and Mirana taking just too much
like
damage.
A 2 second stun when it's maxed, but for some reason, I'm wrong every time I see that.
I think the only longer stun is the... Well, I'm talking just stuns, folks. I'm not talking holds. Oh, never mind. We have a vacuum wall combo. This Roshan attempt suddenly going really wrong. Smash is trying to take it, and they do have the high ground tombstone. But in comes Mr. Alchemist, and he is doing more than enough damage. And Smash still hasn't killed the Roshan. And Abaddon snatches the Aegis. All of that work for nothing.
And the question mark. I love this team.
And yeah, Alk having
Alk
a great time.
Zombies, please.
He is. He's chasing them because his teammates moved away. He actually needs to just stand in the tombstone. He got a bunch of gold there. He just suddenly got 3k gold. I don't know how much of that was from there. So
I thought they were actually going to be able to pick the Rosha. Counter question mark, please. They just arrowed and killed Abaddon, so they got the Aegis.
Yeah, that's not yet. They've got a lot of work to do. They should be able to get him a second time easily, but unfortunately not as good as getting it the Aegis on Smash or on your Windrunner.
Should have noticed his ward being placed if they had him.
Yeah, it could have just been a bit too intense for them right there, being maybe a bit frustrated and not knowing, so. Either way.
Are they smoke up looking get a pick on the Elk? The wards he just popped Chemical Rage, but I think they have the damage to go through it if they get a long enough arrow.
And he is building the standard Alchemist we see. They now know he's there. Between the two of them, they should have a snowball. They're going to have the Searing Chains as well. I don't know if the arrow is coming from anywhere. She's not close enough. And now, turning around on both of them. Smash taking a lot of damage. Can't really stand up to that physical damage. But the Chemical Rage, as you said, there's the arrow. And they get the kill on Alk, getting a killing spree. And a huge Os bounty because he was the top net worth. We'll take a look, but I wouldn't be surprised. Well, actually, this game is in favor of E-Wolves. So, yeah, it is close to 1,000. So...
Still a big kill though. Gives the Ember his mini crit.
Oh.
I also want to point out Potom's probably going Yules. And if this is the case, I love him. This is like my favorite build on Potom. He setups for arrows, makes you a lot more usable as a hero.
I wanted to say that Undying is going Aghanim's. He's maybe going back for a Glimmer Cape, deciding that his team really needs some help and he can't pick up the super greedy item. But 10 Strength Steel on that Decay, it'll certainly help make Alchemist not hit a sword.
Might just be a casual cloak because they have a lot of magic damage in it.
I think...
It has no value to get when you're this high HP.
Radiance. No, I could agree with that. Wyvern also, I wonder if this is just a straight refresher on the Wyvern.
I'd probably go for Lotus Orb though instead because you remove a lot of the stuns.
Oh, we have a snowball into middle. Can they catch him? They get the Ice Shield. They don't have the Flame Guard, and there is a Winter's Curse. A lot of damage coming out onto Stinger, but they should be able to finish off the Gyrocopter and the immediate Remnant away. They'll probably let Stinger fall, but you'll take offlane for their hard carry anytime.
Rip Tusk.
Yeah.
You know, creep away from the snowball too, but Smash is coming back in. Might be able to pick up another kill here.
My goodness, yeah. Van actually lived for years. I actually went to go check out bottom because there was some action down there. A really strange vacuum. I think he expected maybe somebody else on the high ground, and I think that they've killed off Miss Wyvern. She goes
he wanted
down.
To back the Ember to the high ground to save his support. He just missed it.
Yeah, and now with the cover of Moonlit Shadows, they might be able to pick up Alchemist. Chicken, let's see if they can get it. No, they can't get Ida. He's trying to drag him away from the creep wave to get the... Oh.
He's going to set up off stun. He doesn't have vision.
Oh, the...
Yeah, he had to guess. Is the Ember... like, left a second remnant or something on the way back? He would have had the vision. Which would have been... I don't know if it would have been a kill, actually, because of the Abaddon being there.
Yeah, 100%, and it ends up being, I still think, a bit, it's better for E-Wolves here, just because they got the carry, but this game, it's very even. E-Wolves doing a really good job of making it even, though, I have to say, with this Alt, he is pretty far ahead, he's 4k ahead of the Ember, but certainly not one of those very, very one-sided Ember Spirit, Alchemist games we've seen in the past.
I feel like the problem here is because he went the build that he went, he's pretty much got to play... minus a gyrocopter, because he's not getting the space to farm the items he wants. He's just about getting a B at 30 minutes. That's not his fault either. He's been fighting, doing what he needs to do, but there's just no room because the Elk is taking two lanes in his entire woods. He only has Ancients, and even then, the Elk's probably taking those as well. So it's not going to be on the Elk this game, and E-Wolves definitely have the damage to lock him down and kill him.
I feel like Gyrocopter's not going to be online for a long time, and Smash is getting there. He's already got Baby Crit.
He has Big Crit soon, doesn't he?
He can.
The recipe? Yeah, he's got in 600.
Okay, well, there's going to be a stun that's dodged and Smash's Remnants away. So he's doing really well. Saving Grace is E-Wolves, I don't feel, have an easy way to group up their opponents, but even so, you don't want to fight into an Ember Spirit with Daedalus. It's just not fantastic. And we've got a lot of gold up on Doxia. He could combine for Guardian Greaves, but I think he might be worried about getting a Sheepstick online to try and lock down this Ember Spirit.
I think that's what the Midas was for, realizing this game's going to go a bit later. So he can get the bigger item pickups, and the levels are definitely relevant on the hero.
He actually went, something I wanted to mention, but there was way too much action. Doxia went for a level build where he didn't get the wall at least until 9, maybe later. We've got an engagement in middle. Smash doing a lot of damage there, but there is so much backup here, he's just going to remnant away. It's going to be Aghanim's finish on Undying. So he went level 9 before he got the wall, and I feel like you can really get it a lot earlier these days.
The vacuum is useful, though.
Yeah.
They want to fight, like, more often than more cooldown. The levels in vacuum help. You can use it to cancel TPs, which they don't have too many ways of. If you initiate with an Elk stun, and the Wyvern doesn't have D, then they can... Yeah, actually
oh,
going in
Oh, we
top.
Have the aggressive blink in, but that's just Stinger, and they're going to pop that ult. They should be able to kill him off here anyway. Smash comes in, does quite a bit of damage. The mech's going to heal them all up, and they'll get him with the Radiance Bone. That's a cooldown use, so this does mean that E-Wolves can rotate on this, but I don't know if they have any backup for Smash. He should have a remnant out. Oh, this arrow's going to whiff. And now here finally comes the rest of the team, but Masoku might fall before that happens. They get a beautiful sleight of fist off with the crits, and I just don't know if it's enough. Undying's on the back lines, dropping a tombstone, stealing strength, but again, I don't know if it's enough damage there, and Alchemist is just going ham on them all. Undying does manage to kill off Sitok. The gem is on the deck. Undying might get another kill. He is sitting at a casual 2.5k health, which he really shouldn't be. He's gonna take a stun to the face. Smash is coming in. Can there be a sleight of fist of dreams? Gets a lot of crits there, but it looks like M-God is finally gonna fall. Smash coming in now too. He may just go down if he's not careful. M-God is still alive up here. Mystico trying to hide in the trees, but he has no TP and he'll just eventually burn down. The power shot missing as well. Windrunner seeing if she can't be the one to finish them off. Trying to heal up, but there is nowhere to hide here. And any sort of shackle thrown in this area is gonna latch. So another really messy fight coming out of both teams, and apparently it's in favor of Unknown, but it just looked like a mess, that one.
Yeah, the Undying do a lot of work with his DK. I've never seen it in play before, so I'll be interested to see if it actually works out. Like it did that fight. Because if he can be in the front and let the Ember do what he was doing that fight, then it warrants a pickup entirely.
Yeah. So, Either way, Gyrocopter, just forming up down bottom. What do you go here? You're way behind. You need more damage desperately. I mean...
They actually dropped the curse top. They might be able to go off Ember here.
No, he's... Oh my goodness. And by fine, you mean he got out on 40 health there, if we don't account for
regen. I mean, that's an auto attack. That's like an extra second. He had such a big window there. He was fine.
He got the lucky ass crit, though, to kill off Wyvern.
Yeah, but... You know, you have to play around that.
Well, yeah, he left it till the last minute, and again, Smash playing very well in this Ember Spirit. We've all seen him do pretty damn well with that. So, Darkseer gonna be wandering around. He has... Yeah, I think it must be the sheep ship that he's building up for.
Going in.
Can they get the stun? Smash is in a lot of trouble. He doesn't have a second life here, and there was no backup. Mech coming out way too late, and oh, there's going to be the TP attempt, and yeah, he's dead first anyway, so not going to be...
We know the bottom, Sarah, as well. She's fine.
She's fine. So, a little bit of a big...
That was really close.
Yeah. A big turnaround for Unknown, getting themselves firmly back in this game. But again, this game has been so even. With an Alchemist, I really didn't expect us to get a game that has been within 5,000 gold. The entire time, and I have to say, commending E-Wolves for their play, except for the kind of throw over there. Smash just picked up a gem. He bought it himself.
Yeah, because he saw
a bit of frustration.
The Elk. Like, that 3k gold that the Elk just spent on the Shadow Blade is entirely warranted just by killing the Ember One. You know, like, now that they've got the gem, a question of who jumps first. The Shadow Blade is still useful, then it's really good for the Elk. But if he gets countered out by the gem, then he's just going to sell it, and he's probably going to be happy with killing the Ember once, because he just throw away items, like, there's a problem with this hero.
Yeah. He could also... not really anything good with the Silver's Edge here, although it does have a Solinger in it, which tanks you up more. But yeah, as you said, he farmed so fast, he could... It could just literally be a I locked down Ember Spirit once, or forced him to buy a gem item.
Yeah, and if you can kill him to take the gem, then it's value town, right? You force him to buy the gem, and then you take it. Next level.
Yeah. Alk again is sitting at 4k gold. Now, how do you feel? I assume... Oh, he's actually gone for the AC. He's got Manta Illusions. I expect an Octarine to come out, and there's the Sheepstick on to Darkseer. But since Alk could farm it so much faster, I feel like a Sheepstick on him would have been a really nice pickup as well. He's gonna self-stun in this mid lane with his Shadow Blade, but they don't see him at all. I think the Tusk had an idea because he backed up.
I actually like the fact he turned off his radio before he went for that, so they wouldn't see it. But they're coming in with
Smoke. Both teams coming in. Smoke's gonna be broken. We have BKBs already out on Tusk, and there is... What is going on here? We've got a Winter's Curse finally on M-God. No big decay stacks here, but they've used that big cooldown just for one of them. Windrunner also picks up the Wyvern, although she already used her stuff, and it looks like Alg is going down. Glimmer Cape not gonna save him. Searing Chain's totally off the mark. He didn't use the Sleight of Fist there, but they should be able to get to Tusk easily here. Borrow Time Pop, but they'll just kite him until it is off cooldown. They'll even just take him back down from full, give him back all his life, and kill him again. And they get the gem on their side. Did they not notice it? I feel like
Mushoku... I think that's in a place they will notice it. Yeah, someone just pinged it out. Bottom's just too scared of the wall illusion, so she's gonna let the Undying pick it up.
Yeah, a nice turnaround for them. Undying did buy back there. But they'll get the Roshan, and I don't think Darkseer has nearly enough pushing power to do more than tickle this top tower.
No, I like the buyback from Undying just to seal the fight.
Smash is actually bombing bottom, so this is a Windrunner Aegis as she gets bashed up the wazoo.
Oh, Windrunner.
Yeah, that's not it's not good when you're being bashed by Rose.
I mean, he do a lot of damage here. He might force something to happen, but his team's not close. He's not confident now.
Yeah.
Now as you said, it was going to be the refresher from Wyvern.
Yeah, I've seen this before. If you get a little bit of gold, you go straight refresher, so... And yeah. So, we've got a Tornado Creep. They're dominating the Wild Wing Ripper for the Tornado. Thoughts?
Optimal use of your helm. Now sent to Stack Ancient. More optimal use after defending bottom lane.
Okay. Well, either way, we're getting back into it. And,
He's gonna go CS with it bottom instead. This is more optimal play. If he actually micros it to get the CS, this is good stuff. Push the lane out.
I don't think he will.
Oh, they're smoking. I like that. I also like how
the he's trying to CS
boards.
With it, but he missed. Anyway, we have an engagement. That's enough CS action. We have a Shadow Blade leading the smoke charge, and they're going to catch Tusk, but no, they want to go on Van. This should be enough time for the backup, though. Van, still not dead. There's the Aegis pop. Winter's Curse onto Stinger, and they want to back out here. No, they want to keep going in hand. Windrunner, they think, is in a bad position, but she just uses that Windrunner, and here comes Potom. Lands the Arrow of Dreams. There's going to be the second Starfall doing a lot of damage there. We've got Moonlit Shadows saving them all up at Smash. He is ready to go ham, and there's going to be a lot of damage on Gyrocopter Smash. Can he get some more damn crits? There he goes. A big crit. It looks like Mr. Abaddon's gonna get out, but they should be A-OK, and they kill off Alk on the back lines as well.
Yeah, that was just a bit over-aggressive, I feel like. Just the fact Windrunner had Aegis, you should just be happy. As soon as you use your Wyvern ulti, you have to be really careful, because you have no way of locking down the Ember.
Yeah.
I don't think he even got hit in that fight, so
the Ember?
He was just able to do what he wanted. Yeah, well, he's at full health, so either he bottled up or he took very little damage.
He is having
able to do what he wanted.
Even though they're buying a lot of stuff to lock him down, it feels like his game, as you said, has been very easy. And I really think Alk maybe should have thought of a utility item like that to lock him down earlier.
He's going for the Basher now.
Like, yeah,
I don't think he can get it any earlier. But this is why I dislike the Manta, because it's going to build.
Yep, and they're just gonna Searing Chain Sleight of Fist them. They're playing way back. I know the wall is down, but I think you have to stop this or you're gonna lose two lanes of Rax, and I'm pretty scared here for the lineup of Unknown. This could just be them being out, and they already have played a game in this Star Ladder. They are down a set, so they needed a win here, but looking like their chances of Star Ladder maybe being dashed against the rocks by Smash and the rest of his team. I have to say, Masoku, I'm still this Miss Morana, sorry. She is playing really well, and she's got some nice fur shoulders going on.
Oh, the Windrunner? Came on, yeah.
Oh, excuse me. I don't know. I think Morana's cooler. Anyway, let's take a look around.
I mean, it's easier to play Potom, right? You hit one button, and it's like, if it latches, you're like, wow, he did a good job.
I still think the Arrow prediction is really good, but Windrunner is working on her Chrysalis, I assume, after finishing up the MKB, so Alk's Radiant's really not. And this hybrid build where he's kind of that utility, that Snogger Siren Alk, but he's also actually just Shadowblade Basher Alk, I don't understand it. We've got a smoke.
He just adapted the build to the point of the game, and this time. Very ambitious here.
Yeah, he's gonna go down. The rest of the smoke is gonna catch him. Not exactly how you want to use a smoke if you're Unknown. Eventually he'll fall in the snowball for now. Oh, yeah, they actually get him with the Winter's Curse. They might be able to do something here. They drop the wall as well. He's going to use... Oh, Windrunner actually kills off Wyvern as well. Does she get a Shackle of Dreams? She has another one up soon. She should be able to do something here. If they can make sure that this Alk self-stuns, this is going to be really nice, and it's going to set up an Arrow. That was a decently timed one. Windrunner gets the Shackle as well, and now she's pounding into them. Glimmer Caves aren't going to save you here. They try to heal him up, but it's not enough. A Remnant in case they need to finish him off. Using that Windrun just to take no physical damage. Smash is in a lot of trouble, but he's just going to chill on the side. M-God actually not healing him up. He's gonna slide a fist through the wall, but he gets vacuumed in, and now his illusion, it might crit him. There's gonna be a little sheepstick smash. He's critting himself. He's gonna go down to these Darkseer illusion, and that's what happens when you get big. And now they're trying to kill things off. Masoku is going to kill off the Darkseer here. Well played there. Smash unfortunately did fall.
Yeah, but two lucky crits from the illusion.
Two.
Taking him out in the end.
I would like to take a drink, so I want you to talk about what Unknown can possibly do to get back in this game.
Well, the Wyvern getting refreshes is the first step, because at the moment the main form of lockdown on the Ember is the Sheep and the Wyvern ulti, and it's just not enough at the moment when the Alk is doing other things in the fight and the Gyros is not providing enough damage yet. He's so far down on the net worth, he's below the Darkseer, he's pretty full of the Tusk, not where you want your damage dealing carry to be. So, when they get the pressure up from Wyvern, probably their biggest chance.
The Gyrocopter has a casual Sanj, and yeah, they just lost a Rax. All they've got is the tier 2 up top. I don't want to say it's over, but... Okay,
I mean,
it's still possible
still
that E-Wolves...
Sure,
yeah, E-Wolves can make a couple mistakes. So...
I don't think even if E-Wolves make too many mistakes, like, they have to play really well on Unknown, regardless. Mistakes are gonna be there, it's just if you eyes on it.
Oh, she showed that illusion. We are now 10,000 net worth behind. 4 unknown, also 15,000 experience. That one almost the bigger killer, although at this point I think most people maxing out. No, Abaddon still doesn't have that level 3 ult, neither does Wyvern. That one's huge on her. She's gonna have Refresher. If this game keeps going, she's gonna have Refresher. That's... But as we do that, it looks like Van killing somebody off on the bottom lane catches out the gyro again, and she can just push Rax with this, pretty much. Oh,
no buyback on the gyro, and if they find this out, they're going to feel really confident. Elk's probably going to self-stun here as well. Oh, never mind, he has a blink. I did not know about.
Oh, he does actually manage to kill off the Tusk, but now he's being stunned. He's trying to turn around, he's in the Searing Chains, he's taking way too much damage! Casual
question mark, oh. I like this, I like this.
This is the payment from earlier, and in fact, Unknown, it looks like they're gonna be knocked out. Abaddon trying to keep himself alive, Alk does buy back, but as we said, Gyrocopter no buyback. Arrow off the mark for Masoku. And there's gonna be a vacuum, but there's no wall!
I like the fact he held the wall there.
Saving it for the high ground.
If he would have walled there, they would have felt really confident. She'd go mid and feel finish off the racks. But he still has that, probably makes them a bit more hesitant. They're more likely to wait out just and buy more time for Unknown to get what they need to be able to win fights. Things I want to note, Podom has Blink Atos, which is really good at kiting these heroes. Out no BKB. Jaro's BKB is slowly dwindling down. It's at 6 right now. So top of that, Undying has a... He's able to get into the fights better, which I like.
Yeah, we've got a lot of sweet swell pickups and taking a look around. Sorry, I was just trying to make sure we can't hear. I have some noises coming from the other room, so I was hoping you can't all hear them. But Alk, he's just in a bad spot. That Abyssal Blade's not going to be up for a while. I mean, okay, maybe he gets a lucky tombstone again, which he can farm the shit out of, but... It's looking rough for Unknown. Undying also has a Blink Dagger. And a Vlad. Like...
Smash, yeah, I like this Undying build.
Smash has a crap ton of damage coming out for him. It's gonna be a really long Roshan, which I think is fantastic for Unknown. It's gonna help buy them some more time in this game.
Yeah, at the same time... Wolves are close to a set of items if they want it, opposed to the buybacks, which they could definitely look to buy out with Aegis. Because even if they would get white, it's going to take Unknown quite a while to push out lions. So they might be willing to just buy out, knowing that they have two tier twos.
Yeah. What do you feel about stuff like Lotus Orb at this point in the game? Oh, Smash actually going on top, trying to see what he can do to Alk, but he's going to wander off.
Which team?
Really, for either, I feel like Lotus Orb against the Shackle could be helpful, and then, of course, Lotus Orb against the Wyvern. You know that you've got a Sheep Stick flying around.
Tusk could get one, great, but he's really far behind. The Undying could also look for one, because getting more armor on him when he has big HP pulls, very, EHP a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Over on Unknown, if the Undying could get one... Sorry, not the Undying, the Abaddon could get one. I think he's the only real candidate, because Wyvern's 1k away... from his item. Daxia looks like he's going to go for an E-Blade to stop the target Windrunner focus fires dying instantly, which I like. It's a really smart pickup.
Yeah.
I'm sure it will be enough, though.
Yeah, I am not sure as well. While it can definitely debuff a bunch of stuff, it looks like E-Wolves just want to wait for this Roshan and go. And it'll definitely be something where they have everything they need here.
Stunning mid, though.
Yeah, he's gonna see if he can get in. He doesn't. He has the blink, but he didn't. What hit him? I think the power shot hit him.
No, he decided to not go. I think he saw the Ember mid initially, and then as soon as he saw the second hero, he's like, no, I'm not going. It's too risky.
Yeah, I saw his blink go on cooldown, so I wasn't sure if maybe the power shot hit him before he went out.
He just blinked back.
Okay.
He was here scouting the high ground, then he just blinked back. However, the Ember's invis right now. They're too scared to go, but they're getting wrapped around on here.
Yeah, and this is better than the smoke. Actually, the tombstone on the high ground again. You can still get decay stacks from up there. Cold Embrace, but they have a lot of magic damage. Wall Vacuum combo and the Winter's Curse. Can Gyro do something? Big cooldown gonna come out. And Masoku Van both going down. That's a godlike streak. And suddenly, the rest of E-Wolves, they are in a bad spot. This long Roshan timer really punishing them. And both teams know the Roshan is up. They're gonna back out, but at the same time, who's that working on their tower? Windrunner, she's bought back. Van is going in. If they kill her again, she is just dead, though. But instead, she's gonna make sure she gets Elaine of Rax. She does. She actually already used the Windrun. She's gonna Windrun right by them. She needs to get that blink off, but one more second. She has to not be a piggyback in back. I don't know if she has this. This might have just been a death for her, but she just kills off Darkseer. Even if she goes down, she's gotten something. She now has the Windrun up. She still needs to blink away, and she may go down to the rocket. She's at 150 health, and he actually uses... Oh gosh, this is not good for Van. Oh no, Van walks right into the Alchemist and both Van and Amgon. That is a dieback, but if they can kill off Alk, there's the cooldown. I don't think this was good for E-Wolves. I think that was a really atrocious team fight for them. Yes, they got a secondary Rax, but they lost a lot, and they might have lost Roshan here.
I think if they go for Rosh, Smash is able to mess around with them too much so that they don't feel confident.
That was a 9k gold swing, by the way.
Yeah, Wyvern getting his refresher now, so he has both assaults in 17 seconds. Which is where Van and Smash have to be really careful. Smash actually opting for either a third crit, an MKB, or a Divine, which I think is a bit overkill. Rather see a blink or some kind of mobility, I think. He's actually going in mid, but he's on his own here, he could die.
He could die, in fact, he's getting Atos'd up, they're gonna try to kite him, BKB, you still take damage though, physical, and they might not be able to kill off the Alchemist with the backup coming out. Searing Chain, Sleight of Fist combo, it does work, but Monta's out of it. I was going to say that that Mr. Gyrocopter, he has gone Sand and Yasha at 46 minutes in, I think is about when he got that, before the team fight, probably a bit earlier, but Sand and Yasha probably going to make a Satanic, he is still really lacking damage, and I feel like Sand and Yasha this late into the game, not stellar.
It's most efficient choice of item, though.
But he didn't have it earlier, I feel like it's good early, maybe something else later, or just still sitting with that Sand and Yasha.
I mean, I think it's fine, honestly.
Oh. Arrow just misses the Roshan, but now they know, everybody knows, there's going to be a Tombstone on the high ground as well. There's the leap, the blink up there by Masoku, and now they can get a lot of damage, but it looks like Tusk, he's taking too much of it. Where is Smash? He needs to be sleight of fisting around the pit. Abaddon does manage to kill off Stinger. I don't know if Stinger, he does use his buyback there. Smash is locked in that Winter's Curse, but it is not going to last for long enough. Arrow hits on the Wyvern, who used the Refresher. Not going to be able to get that off twice. Smash might be able to escape. In comes Masoku again, full-stopping himself down, but the Alkstone's coming out, and M-God, that's going to be a dieback for him. Not much. Wyvern, she still has the Winter's Curse if she wants. Gyrocopter on the backlines dies to Windrunner. Must have been way over to the right of the fight of where we're watching. Effigy's going down in the base and the other tier 4. Snowball in, Arrow gonna hit. This is a totally dead Wyvern, and they've gotten her. And now they're gonna be forced to use the buybacks on E-Wolves. Oh, sorry, on Unknown.
Who do they have? They only have one buyback. Okay, the Elf just came up.
It is rough. I definitely thought that team fight was going to go the way of Unknown with the refresher coming out of the Wyvern, but just the surprise arrow onto her, meaning she couldn't use it to continue to lock down Smash. Not enough.
Game saving arrow, honestly. Yeah.
And I think it was especially good because I don't think the refresher had been scouted yet.
So... I think they saw it.
Okay, either way, Smash was caught out of position and she could have just used the two of them, but of course arrowed up. We're gonna see maybe just a siege on their base. They could also wrap around on top, but instead they're just gonna focus fire on that tower. Yeah, he is gonna self-stun over there. Not too bad, but here comes the Undying. Actually, surprised Windrunner didn't blink in for that Shackle. Drops the Tombstone, that's gonna go down fast. Gyrocopter finally uses the buyback. A wall is down, Gyrocopter's coming in, they have no more tier 4s. But at the same time, this might have been an overextension from E-Wolves. BKB popped, and now they're walking in. They're in the Snowball, saving lives! That's Alk dead, he immediately uses buyback. Greedy is down for the count, no buyback on him. Gyrocopter, if he goes down here, it's a dieback, and E-Wolves very happy that they forced those two buybacks and got the tier 4.
Yeah, really well played there by the Tusk, saving the Ember from his... I think he got Abyssaled after the stun, so he would have died for sure. But he got Snowballed, he ate the cheese, and then I think he got some crits, which killed the Elk.
100%. And how do you feel about this Ember Spirit build? Double crit? I mean, I feel like there aren't enough heroes to say that you're going to go a second Battle Fury.
I think this is a better build, personally. Double crits just your chances of critting pretty
good story. Yeah, no, it definitely does.
I'm not exactly sure on the map, so that's why
it pops one, then it checks one, and then it checks the other, is my understanding. So you've got a lot more chances. Also, I wanted to mention that Ember Spirit, just because of how well the rest of Ewolves has been playing, we really have to... Smash is getting a lot of kills, and he's clearly playing well, but the rest of Ewolves is enabling him to play such a gloss cannon. He does not have a single defensive item on Ember Spirit. Rarely. I mean, he had the drums, but he sold them. Rarely do you see an Ember Spirit who's so free to play this aggressively, this gloss cannon, and Ewolves just setting it up for Smash.
Yeah, the Tusk is one of the best heroes for this. Right now he has BKB, so you can always get in there to help him out with the Blink as well.
Yeah.
Pretty much one of the best heroes, I think, to enable builds for this. You have the frontline from the Undying, and the Windrunner is like your follow-up damage as well, so... Multiple heroes, they need to focus.
We've got Smash wandering around, thinking about going in. Both of our teams have to be playing very carefully, and we only have another 2 minutes on that Aegis, so they can actually kind of slow siege here, Ewolves, but they do have to be a bit careful, you know, you take too long.
Arrow's hitting Darkseer.
Oh goodness, they're going in, they use the Winter's Curse onto Van, they've also got a lot of damage coming out from the Gyro, but can they follow up on Van? Refresher is popped, so there's a secondary Winter's Curse, and Smash, he's in a lot of trouble, the second Winter's Curse on him, he is knocked out for the count, he does have buyback. Van, gonna probably be using that Aegis here, and it is not a good spot, but immediately the buyback from Smash and Van, now ready to go in ham, has used that Aegis, we're looking for more kills, there could be a stun though out, in comes Masoka, gonna be the one who takes that stun, but Snowball picking her up and saving her, and now it looks like the Alk is finally going down. This is probably just GG. If the missed chances stop, they should be able to kill off the dogs here or just work on the tower. Shackle onto Wyvern, Shackle of Dreams, Arrow as well, hitting onto Z-Talk, and that is GG. Unknown, unless something really weird happens in their group, is out, I believe, of their group. Two losses. Yeah, they're gonna fountain farm a little bit, but that's the GG called.
Really well played by Elite Wolves. I like the fact they're bringing bottom into the game again. They played around it really well. And the casual question mark. I like this.
Oh, yeah. And they actually asked folks in the lobby, Zatok asked how much old chat was allowed. So,
I mean, as long as it's not offensive, right? A question mark.
No, I think either a ton asked. Yeah, a question mark. It could, in fact, just be confusion. Once again, I'm Mama Down Under. I've been joined by PQMZ. We'd love your feedback on how to get better as casters. You can give us your feelings, thoughts, all of that. Rainbows, butterflies, on Twitter, Llama Down Under, Facebook, Llama Down Under, or Twitter.